Well, earlier I made an absolutely classic mistake. So my intention was to explain to anybody that's watching how you take the drive shaft out of the hub on the rear suspension. And I made a fantastic video, awesome, best one I've ever made, except I did it in time lapse. So here we are. All right, so I'm gonna give you a quick rundown on how you do it, and then there's a video of me actually taking this particular hub apart, right? Basically, the rear drive shaft unit in an E-type is that you have a drive shaft. It has actually has two UJs, one here, and then also one here. The drive end that's going into the wheel goes through this hub carrier, and there's a bearing arrangement inside the hub carrier, and there's an inner drive shaft which is here that fits into the spline. This spline fits into the female spline on the actual hub itself. That hub is installed from this direction. This bearing is rolling against the hub, and then all of this is assembled up and is basically clamped together using this bolt and this very heavy duty washer. To get this part away from that part, you have to have a very special tool, a hub puller from Jaguar. And I'm gonna just show you basically how that works. All right, so put this to one side. So it's a very, very heavy piece. Cost a fortune, by the way. This engages on the external threads. Those threads are used to secure the hub cap, actually on the car, which secures the wheel onto onto the vehicle, right? So this unit has got a big female thread inside, and you would see the spline shaft through the hub itself, through the hub carrier itself. You would see the spline shaft sticking out, and we're basically putting in a threaded insert which you tighten, and as you tighten it pushes the shaft out. So it's pretty a significant piece of kit. So what you basically do is tighten this up. As you're tightening it up, this shaft is coming this way, disconnecting. Took quite some effort. I'm actually surprised at how much effort it took. I don't normally rely on a big hammer to do this kind of work, but the principle is that you basically hold the hub and you tighten the thread, right? Hold the hub. Tighten the thread, and eventually they disengage. So the video that's following shows exactly how that's done. So once you separate them, this is what the inside of the hub carrier looks like. I call it an upright. I'm going to change the bearings on all of this. This is the other side. It's just gunk, but it's actually good gunk. It's this grease in here looks very clean. I'm not seeing anything unusual in the bearing. And I'd already cleaned up the bearings once, and they look okay. I will replace everything. What you'll see is that once it's cleaned up, you go from something that's looking like that something that's looking like that. And begins to look something like this. So this is after the first round of cleaning, and there's a lot more effort yet left in here to do to polish it up and clean it up a bit more. But pretty comprehensive. So this is what the clean one looks like inside. I haven't taken the bearings out yet, but it gives you an idea. So what the other side looks like. This princess is getting new hips. She will be able to do 150 mile an hour.